Audioguide is a music theater piece about various topics such as hypermodernity, 9/11, money, the differentiation of society, but it's also a piece on the extended definition of music, a conceptualism opera with music but also with speech and with a lot of video parts, creating an own music theater language where all these components are not melting together, but they function as a constellation. Only after 1 hour, the first actor enters the stage, and then there is over 20 minutes of speech only. So this is a kind of statement for not constantly playing music during a music theater.
The compression method of a big benefit for mankind.
You could call these spoken parts a sort of recitativo, but it is still musicalized in a way with these notation miniatures, or even in the talk with Stefan Fricke, these censorship tones could be listened to as a sort of music ready-made.
Wir sind noch beim Westdeutschen Rundfunk, da gab es noch Kollegen vom Südwestdeutschen Rundfunk.
These 7 hours are filled with a lot of small scenes, as well as longer scenes, loosely connected, but all close to each other, in a sort of so-called Petersburg hanging. The piece takes 7 hours without break, which means it forces people to act. Or I prefer saying, it empowers people to act. It is like in an exhibition, you can move freely on your own, which results then in a social sculpture. People are standing outside discussing the piece, whereas inside it is still continuing. During the entire piece, there are again and again strategies of extra wage, of surpassing borders, not only with this supersized length, but also, for example, having a very ordinary talk on stage where things are spoken out which are normally spoken out only in the pub, or with this quite extreme and in fact really dangerous destruction of over 100 violins. During the piece, a big amount of violins gets destroyed and people complain about that. But this is just a possibility of stage design, like all other stage designs in ordinary theater pieces. And after the last rendition in every theater piece, the stage ends up in the trash can. So here it is made transparent what happens anyway. And later we've built, for example, a big string out of the destroyed violins. And even the audience started, while the piece was still going on, to grab fragments of the violins. As I used to say, composing means to steal an instrument. The audience shouldn't get something from a performance. The audience should steal something from it. I also included a Facebook discussion, which really took place 2 years before. It was a quite heated discussion about a protest action I did in Donaueschingen 2012. The main reason why I use this text is because I think this text is very good. It is a very enlightening discussion, giving a lot of insight, and already on Facebook it was a kind of a theater play. Another reason is, also with the talk with the journalist Stefan Fricke on stage, the fusion of art and life. The things I have to struggle with in real life, I also should deal with in my art. So it's about expression, it's real life expression. But also throughout the piece there is a series of parts which are fairly abstract, working with very elemental movements. The circle, walking straight ahead, falling down again and again, or just playing all possible 680 three-tone chords, which are possible in a certain range on the keyboard. A general idea I'm following in my work is what I call prepared listening. In addition to sound, there is an information given with text or with video or with performance, and in relation with this information, the perception of sound is shaped, sometimes almost aggressively, so the listener is forced to take care about his perception. And he gets aware of his perception, he's questioning it, he has to question it. For example, when we poison a Mozart piece, because we say that some subliminal frequencies were added that contain a preacher's speech.
All of you, just let it take effect on you, yeah? Because the goal of tonight's show is that you will all convert to Catholicism. The rules are, go to the toilet shitting. Measure the time from the first touch of your shit in the toilet bowl until flushing. Afterwards, play a C major chord on the organ as long as the measured time.
Some people have the impression that concepts create a didactical situation where they are told, okay, this is the concept, and now listen to the music. But that's a superficial opinion. The concept is not the interpretation, but these pieces ought to be interpreted as poems. When we see these videos with women on levels, and the pianist is pressing the pedals at the same time, of course this is first of all very obvious. And she's playing tones then, but this piece is then about weight metaphorically, about expressive weight, about the pure force of the feet and the resulting indirect expressive effects of the piano pedals on the piano keys, and then giving back an expression to these videos, to these feelings on the weight levels, and thus it is about beauty in the arts and beauty on the marriage market, connected to a sort of American abstract music sound from the 1950s. The shutter technique I'm using has created a misunderstanding to some people. They see this Shostakovich and immediately think, oh, okay, he wants to destroy music. But in fact, it's much more than an intellectual concept. I am fascinated by the result of this shutter principle. All these tiny fragments could be regarded as own music pieces, each with a micro dramaturgy. Dullop, dullop, dullop. So, where you can ask yourself, for example, is there an accent at the beginning or is there an accent at the end when there is the cut? And then, of course, these fragments are connected to each other. You could imagine the missing 50%. Next, I'm alternating between two sources and so on. So, of course, this is not anti-music. It is, again, music. My conceptual aesthetic is working a lot with individual ideas, and they all deal with content and often with political ones. But you could also describe it as a formal strategy. A concept is a form, Or like Robert Musil said, an idea is the smallest possible whole, das kleinste mögliche Ganze. And with these units I'm working.